Nixon lost 18 minutes. Obama's now lost 2 years of email.
These things don't just disappear.
This is outrageous.
And these emails hold a secret, and all of a sudden we're asked to believe they have disappeared into thin air.
I don't think anybody believes it.
Well, a new twist, and it is a fascinating one in the IRS targeting scandal. 2 years of Lois Lerner's emails disappear. Poof. The IRS telling congressional investigators that the emails were lost in a computer crash, but House Oversight Committee Chair Daryl Issa says emails don't just disappear without a trace unless that was the intention. Chairman Issa joins us. Nice to see you, sir.
Well, thanks for having me back on. And Greta, I think the American public gets it that when a disk drive, quote, crashes, the data is still there. And competent authorities can recover virtually, if not all, of that data. It's clear that this drive went to the boneyard at a convenient time with convenient information.
All right. Are you saying that it can still be recovered, or are you saying that they intentionally offloaded it so that it can't be?
The Federal Records Act requires that this data be retained.
All right. Well, did they retain it, or did they offload it?
When they destroyed the disk without informing the National Archives, they violated the law. The National Archives has now opened an investigation completely separate from ours into this series of wrongful destructions.
And I've got the letter here from the archives.
Paul Webster.
Dated June 17th. Okay, but was it deliberate or accidental or incompetent? However you want to describe it. Was this deliberate destruction?
I had a conversation with the archivist. His people train all of government on what to do. And if your policy is not to retain on your servers past 6 months, which is what we now understand, and you tell your individual high-ranking officials they should retain the appropriate documents under the Federal Records Act, then you know those drives contain
that. But there's being deliberate knowing that you didn't do it, and there's doing deliberately because you're doing something sinister because you're trying to hide something. Those are two different things. Which is it?
The person who made the decision not to have this drive recovered is the person who took the fifth, Lois Lerner.
Right. Now, she wrote emails, like, for instance, the FEC, so even if she had a crash, whoever received it at the FEC or if she wrote to the DOJ or anything, they should have them.
Greta, every email she sent out went to somebody on the other end. The problem is, except for the NSA under this administration, who has all those emails?
Well, we can't drop a subpoena. I mean, you make the FEC go to work, make the DOJ go to work. You have subpoena power.
But remember, much of her activity could have been with the committee to reelect President Obama. It could have been with
Can you serve a subpoena on them?
I can serve a subpoena on the Democratic National Committee.
Well, get going.
But in fact, that kind of a fishing expedition is what Henry Waxman did as a predecessor of mine, and he did so because he just generally had an idea. We would like to be pragmatic and positive and reasonable. But right now, when the IRS falsely holds this information back that they knew under multiple commissioners, our first responsibility, Dave Camp and myself, is to put the commissioner in front of us and ask him what did he know and when did he know it and why didn't he tell us?
Well, he testified in February and he didn't tell you then, and apparently they're supposed to know it by then. So anyway,
he was clearly not forthcoming, and he was right on the edge of perjury when he told our committee that in fact it could take up to 2 years to get this data, when he knew at that point it could take up to forever.
Mr. Chairman, nice to see you, sir.
Thanks, Greg.